The spokesperson of the Sultanate of Sulu, Abraham Ijirani, says Sultan Jamalul Kiram III has yet to hear the details of the meeting between the Department of Interior and Local Government Secretary Marohas and the Sultan's brother, Sultan Ismail Kiram II. In an interview on DZMM, Ijirani added the two Kirams are scheduled to meet to talk about what was discussed during the meeting.
Tama ko ang sabi ni kagalang-galang secretary, yun ay para bagang doon mag-umpisa ang talking points doon sa disengagement kung ano ang mga mekanismo.
Opo.
At si Sultan Bantilan, Ismail Kiram Pisikan, ay ibibrief pa ho niya si Sultan Jamalul Kiram doon sa entirety ng meeting nila kahapon.
Meanwhile, Ijirani also said he was able to talk on the phone with Raja Muda Kiram at around 2 a.m. this morning. The spokesperson said Kiram's group is still in Lahad Datu. On the line now is Interior and Local Government Secretary Ma Rojas. Good morning, Secretary.
Hello, good morning, Ron.
Mr. Secretary, will you be able to share with us the details of what you talked about with Ismail Kiram, sir?
Well, Ron, let's just leave it in the generalities. I think that the situation is complicated enough. The Sultan Ismail and I had a good meeting yesterday where they expressed certain concerns. I have briefed the president about it. The president gave certain instructions for the conveyance of some of these questions to the Malaysians through Secretary Albert Del Rosario, and let's just await what these developments are.
Yes, sir. Why won't you be able to tell us the specifics, sir?
Well, these are ongoing negotiations, ongoing talks, and these are quite complex, and it is best that that this not be complicated by having it in media, you know.
Okay, sir. Who initiated the meeting, sir? Was it you who wanted to talk to the Kirams, or the Kirams wanted to talk to the government?
Well, the Sultan Ismail sent word that he wanted to talk with me while I was in Sambuanga in Basilan. Mm-hmm. We had a short chat while there. I said that what's important is that this must be authorized or sanctioned because it's quite difficult to be receiving so many messages or so many different messages from various parties, both directly and through the media. And so General Ardo of West Mincom, General Kerol of the PNP, and Governor Najib were present in this meeting, and he said that he will consult. And so anyway, over the weekend, last Sunday, they sent word if we could meet on Monday. So I said I will clear my schedule, and so that's why we met yesterday.
And just to clarify, sir, did Sultan Ismail say that this is he was an official representative of the Sultanate of Sulu sent by, and this meeting is approved by Jamalul Kiram, sir?
That was his representation, and I take him at his word. But I think, Ron, all of these have been confirmed already in the newspapers. I mean, you know, there have been mutual expressions of authority that were granted to Sultan Ismail.
With your talk with Ismail, sir, did they reiterate their claim on Sabah?
It was not a... there was some mention of that, but I think that, you know, I think the talks were more in nature of what do we do now, you know? I expressed the president's concern. Is the president's primordial concern is the safety of the Filipinos and the livelihood of 800,000 Filipinos there. And so I said, you know, let us separate the claim or what, you know, the claims that your family and or the government may have from the situation, which is dangerous and life-threatening for many of our Filipinos, as well as livelihood threatening for all the others in Sabah now. No? In fact, we already have evacuees or returnees who are fearful of their situation, and it's several boatloads, several hundreds, if not thousands, already have returned. All of them are, in a way, victims of this goings on.
Did Ismail mention any kind of intention of pulling out their members from Sabah, sir?
Well, I think that the questions related to Prime Minister Razak's pronouncements, and they wanted some clarifications, and I said I would convey this to the president, which I did, and the president authorized DFA Secretary Del Rosario to convey these questions to the Malaysians as well.
Okay, sir. When will we be able to find out the specifics of your meeting, sir?
Well, when the Malaysians get back. Yeah.
So that's the only time when a reply, an official reply from the Malaysian government, from the, can we call them requests by the Philippine government? Are they requests? Are they clarifications?
I think that they're clarifications.
Okay. Sir, we are also aware that, of course, we've been reporting that the number of Filipinos from Sabah have been coming back home, most of them without legal documents coming from Sabah, Malaysia, and have been affected by the situation there. Now, we've also been reporting that these areas in the country have been having problems with the influx of people coming from Malaysia, Filipinos coming from Malaysia. Is the DALG providing assistance to those local governments, or is it just going to be the DSWD responsible for that?
Well, the entire government, the president is on top of the situation. The president has directed the various government agencies, the ILG, the SWD, Department of Agriculture, NFA, the regional governor, Mujib Hataman, the LGU heads by the governors and the mayors, to all work together to ensure that there is adequacy of food supply, that there is adequacy of shelter, there is adequacy of medical personnel in the event that these returnees come in larger numbers. No? Right now, they are being handled, but as you can imagine, the local governments are relatively small, so they will need the help of the national government, and the national government already has pre-positioned. In fact, the president's instruction is to pre-position in excess of whatever the estimates may even be, just to make sure that there is more than enough food, more than enough grain, particularly rice, canned goods, milk, etc., in these localities.
Okay. One more thing, sir. Going back to the meeting, and you said that you have reported already to the president about what you talked about with Ismail Kiram. Was the president satisfied with your meeting with Kiram? Did he ask for more? Was he okay with what you told Kiram and what the Kirams asked for?
Well, the president has been aware of the of all of the developments. It's not for me to say whether he is satisfied or not. His entire government is dedicated to uplifting the plight of all of our Filipino brethren, particularly, you know, the 200 who are there, who are imperiled, the 800,000 innocents who are there just seeking livelihood, whose livelihood now is possibly jeopardized, the returnees, evacuees, who are seeking safety back here. So the president is making sure that all the Filipinos and that his entire government is attending to all of these needs. Kumbaga nakatutok, you know, that we are all alert and that we are all working to ensure whatever help that we can give for the Filipinos.
Okay, DILG Secretary Marhoas, thank you very much, sir, for talking with us this
morning.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.